Lesson 2 outlines our first process in the service design book, which is called Service Catalog Management, and this lesson has three objectives. First, we'll understand the types of services that are stored in the service catalog. Next, we'll learn the two aspects of the service catalog, and we'll finish up with a short list of duties for the person filling the service catalog manager role. For the foundation exam, it's okay to think of the service catalog management process as mostly administrative. The main objectives of service catalog management are really just to maintain a service catalog and to ensure that it's accurate, up-to-date, and visible to those who are allowed to see it. It's a one-stop shopping place that provides information about all the services that are currently in production, which are also known as operational services, as well as those services that are on the brink of going live. You'll see that I have a picture of a menu down here on the slide. Let's talk about why. Don't forget that the service catalog is a tool that's part of an even larger tool called the service portfolio. During the process of service portfolio management, which we covered back in service strategy, we learned that the service portfolio is a list of all services that we provide today, that we used to provide, or services that we are planning to provide in the future. During the service portfolio management lesson, I compared the service portfolio to what is in an executive chef's mind. The service pipeline contains dishes that are being tested out or are waiting for the right season to come around so the right vegetables can be acquired. The retired services contains the dishes that were once offered but aren't offered any longer, and the service catalog is a list of the dishes that are being offered today. You'll see here that the service catalog also contains services that are being prepared for operational running. We didn't say this before, but I'm telling you now. Think of these services like the turkey that's in the oven right now, but it won't be ready for another 3 hours. It's ready enough to be on the menu, but it's not quite ready enough to make it to your plate yet. In business language, think of these services like those IT services that are in the staging lane. They are fully built, documented, and ready to be deployed, but they're just awaiting their official go-live date. So the service catalog is the only portion of the service portfolio that the customers can see, because it's really the only portion that matters to them. Just like when you go to a restaurant, the only thing that you really care about is what you can order right now. For the exam, you'll need to remember that the service catalog contains details of all operational services, as well as those services being prepared for operational running. There are two aspects of the service catalog. If you're first starting out with a service catalog in your company today, you probably won't have either of these two aspects yet. These things are developed as an organization's service management implementation matures. The two aspects of the service catalog are called the technical service catalog and the business service catalog. But most organizations start out with what's shown here in yellow, which is just a plain old service catalog. It's just a list of the IT services that are offered. Your next step would be to create a business service catalog, which contains all of the IT services we provide to the customers, which again are shown here in yellow, but it also has the relationships to the business units and the business processes that rely on those IT services that are shown here in blue. So this big blue rectangle here encompasses our business service catalog. The second aspect of the service catalog is called the technical service catalog, which contains, again, all of the IT services that are delivered to the customer, which are shown here in yellow, along with all the relationships to the supporting IT services, shared services, and service components that are necessary to provide these services to the business. The business doesn't really care about this underlying technical stuff, so the business never needs to see this stuff in red. For the exam, you'll just need to know that the two aspects of the service catalog are called the business service catalog and the technical service catalog. As we learned way back in Chapter 1 when we were laying down some basic vocabulary and concepts, we learned that every process needs to have a process owner. So the process owner of the service catalog management process is called the service catalog manager. The way we can figure this out is you take the name of the process, in this case, it's service catalog management, and then you just stick manager on the end. So the process owner of the service catalog management process is the service catalog manager. So this first bullet here encapsulates all of the duties that every process owner has for the process that they own. You might remember that every process owner has responsibilities that spell out DEMI, D-E-M-I. And if you need a reminder, you can find these in your book. The Service Catalog Manager, again, the process owner of the Service Catalog Management process, would D in DEMI, stands for document the Service Catalog Management process. E, they would educate everybody on how to use this process and then ensure that folks are using it correctly. And then they would M, measure the process for progress, effectiveness, efficiency, and cost. And then they'd I, continually improve the process. In addition to those DEMI duties that comes with being a process owner, your service catalog manager will also produce and maintain a service catalog, will make sure that all of those operational services, as well as those being prepared for operational running, are recorded in your service catalog. They'll also make sure that your service catalog is accurate, up to date, and also consistent with the service portfolio. And don't forget, the service catalog is just a subset of the service portfolio. And lastly, they'll also make sure that the service catalog is adequately protected and backed up. And that wraps up service catalog management. So let's move on to lesson 2, which is our longest lesson, which discusses service level management.